the ancient Roman Empire, the word genius was dedicated to the person's unique inner spirit that protected and guided a person through life. In the Middle East, this term is found in the word genie that was hidden in the Aladdin's lamp, and when awakened, can grant any wish of a holder. It is obvious that the ancients believe in something beyond human intelligence, far wiser and intelligent than human beings. The spiritual world was much more appreciated and honored in ancient times than in modern times, where the intellect took the rule of the mighty one. The giftedness in a child was in ancient communities recognized immediately. That was essential for the development of gifts in a child and for the well-being of the community. The child lived in fulfilled life, gifts were useful and active, and the community was whole. Could you imagine that in ancient communities, the shaman, the medicine man, was not really gifted for healing, or that the warrior was not strong and fast enough to kill the animal or the enemy, or that the chief was not wise, focused, and strategic enough to lead the whole community to prosper? The tribe would vanish. The ancient fundamental existing code depend on early recognizing, accepting, and admiring gifts of each individual. Nowadays, it is very rare that a person is aware of her or his genius. Giftedness is buried deep in subconscious, under the feelings of shame, guilt, and fear. It takes a lot of sessions in therapy to soften the heart resistant in people to accept their giftedness, which exists in every one of us. The tall poppy syndrome managed to deeply root fear in our little hearts. When a poppy flower is cut down because it is different than others, this punishment, it is so deeply rooted in society and doesn't allow others to thrive, to grow, to invent, to innovate, to create, and it's pushed down in a level to the level of the rest of society. My personal experience as a gifted child was similar. Constant feelings of rejections, but at the same time, an awareness that I was rejected also when I was pretending to be normal, which took immense part of my energy. Cycle of pain, confusion, and madness. Few years ago, I started my journey as a therapist for gifted to help and guide people who felt lost and confused as I was as a gifted person. All my life, I was constantly rejected, misunderstood, and considered overwhelming for my surroundings because my mind, my heart, my energy was different, more complex, far more intense to handle. It took me years of self-work and self-love to grant myself and get enough inner strength to start reaching to the stars with the supportive and unique power of my heart. I firmly step on my path to educate, to help and heal, and guide people who are willing to unleash their inner unique potentials and talents to stand for the new world to come.